I beseech you, my lords, answer me a question. Is girl the proper title for one who, had things turned out a bit differently, might have been our queen?
Forks stopped on the way to mouths, and once again Sarene found herself the focus of the room's attention. This time, however, the looks were slightly more appreciative. Kaiyan nodded, and Lukel shot her an encouraging smile.
I warn you, my lords, forbid her or accept her as you will, but do not treat her with disrespect. Her Aerilish title is no stronger and no more flimsy than our own. Where we ignore one, we must ignore all others.
I applaud your caution, my lords. You have good reason to be careful. You have lost your patron, the only man who could have given you a measure of protection. Remember, however, that I am his wife. I'm no substitute for the prince, but I am still a connection to the throne. Not just this throne, but others as well.
That's well and good, Sarene. But connections and promises will do us little good in the face of the king's wrath.
Little good is not the same as no good, my lord. My lord Duke, I will never know the man that I now call my husband. You all respected, and if I am to believe, my uncle loved Raoden, but I, who should have come to love him best, can never even meet him. This work in which you are involved was his passion. I want to be part of it. If I cannot know Raoden, at least let me share his dreams.
Roiel watched her for a second, and she knew that he was measuring her sincerity. The Duke was not a man to be fooled by mock sentimentality.
I have no problems with her staying.
Neither do I.
Sarene looked at the others. Lukel was smiling openly at her speech, and the stately mercenary, Lord Eondel, was nearly in tears.
I give my assent to the lady.
Well, if Roiel wants her here, then I have to object out of principle. But happily, it looks as if I'm outvoted. I get tired of looking at the same crusty old faces anyway.
Then she stays?
She stays.